Christ, the exalted. In Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
We sit at the presence of the Lord.
Open up the Bible to the book of James, chapter 3. We read verse 10 to 12. The book of James, chapter number 3. We read it from verse 10 to number 12. Out of the same mouth proceeded blessing and cursing. My brethren, this thing ought not so to be. Don't a fountain send forth at the same place sweet water and bitter? Can a fig tree, my brethren, bear a olive berry, either a vine fig? So can no fountain both yield salt and fresh? Here is talking about the power of tongue. And we are going to look at this particular evening, holiness and the tongue. It's very, very important to understand what our mouth can do, the result we can have. If you really want to live a spiritual life, you must only, your holiness will start from your mouth. Holiness commences from our tongue. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you can hear, Bible makes us understand every idle word will be judged at the last day. Idle words are the words which are spoken carelessly without meditating. There are some people who say that just only be their own by CPR. They say that it's in the life. They don't wait, they don't articulate, they don't even think, how will it sound, what will it be? And that's why you must be very, very careful as a Christian. He said, tongue is an instrument of destruction, disunity, discord, disaffection, rumor, mongering, sowing discord among brethren. Tongue is an instrument of sowing discord, destruction, rumor, splitting brothers and sisters. And you discover that when such a thing will happen is when the person will join a certain group against you. I had it. I do it. We say it. But we need to know that our thoughts are meant to be sanctified. That's why it is a signal to show us that the death of Jesus Christ, that he made a promise to his disciples, I will send you the power of the Holy Ghost like the flame of God. Come. Come on fire. That's why it was not on your head. That means the power, the life is in the tongue. Prosperity lies in your tongue. Failure lies in your tongue. What you speak, what you say, what we are going to be tomorrow will start from what you say today. Praise the Lord. And you people that laugh and ridicule people, it is very, very bad. You must understand that you must use your tongue very, very well. The problem of the tongue can be traced as lack of holiness. Problem of the tongue can be traced as lack of what?
Holiness.
If you are holy, you can be able to control your tongue. James chapter 1, we read verse 26. The book of James chapter 1, I read verse 26. He said, if anyone among you seek to be religious and ridicules his tongue, but deceives his own heart, this man religion is in vain. You call yourself, you go to church, you are born again, but your tongue is not there. Look at a person that is on traveling, because life is a journey. Anywhere they want to stop, I like to eat any food. They bring the roasted meat to eat. Gaba, he eats. Anywhere he eats. Before you know it, I am a boy of God or a prophet. just know, listen carefully before you say anything. If someone has written something to you, listen. Be very, very careful. Because life and death, they are in power of God. That's why you see so many churches, they are in trouble. They are having a problem in the churches. Because of gossip and rumor, speculations, a lot of these character assassination, exaggeration and lying. Things they just feel like. Someone when I walk one day say, Pastor, I'm already compromised with me. I love people to react to this. How do you know that they are compromised? You didn't even hear what he said. You didn't know what he said. What is compromising? You didn't wait to see the action. You already said compromise. A sister who will be there and say, I know that's where you need to live. I'm like, no. So many families are having a problem today because of mouth. People, when you go to Iran and say, how come so and so is coming around to marry her? How is she? Say that one. Why was she married that one? That one don't go now. You know since you don't go to abortion. Are you with her? You don't know. Use your mouth to kill yourself. But remember, whatever a man sows, he shall do what? Are you the only one? This is actually a question. Answer the question. I've never been in a ministry. When did a man want to help you to go and answer the prophets? Some of our prophets that are very stupid, God forgive me, to answer you go to you. Okay, don't give me the money. If you give me the money, you'll scatter. I look at him and say, what kind of money did I give? He said, okay, when God gave me money, God did not consult anybody. If you are not even right to take the money, he gave it to you because of he wants you to perfect your life, give it to other people. If I give you money, if you give me the money, it's 2 months, and that money give you, then you are helping it to somebody. The only way, cross. Somebody gave me money many years ago. When I was a friend starts smoking, you won't call me and won't forget that like that. He said, because he says, small money, when it's a big money like that. She gave me $10,000 of money that you add it to your business. Do the business with the money, pay me back. She didn't want me to pay her. She didn't tell me. She only used that avenue to make sure that I use the money with it just me. How many years to come? I came back to God and said, I didn't ask you to give me the money. I just want to know how you are going to use the money. Today. It's not a must. You know, Mr. Kelly said I should give you money to start now. How do you think? That guy. Now, remember, you have two Kenya. But remember, in every man, there are certain things that is good about the person. They don't give the guy like a character assassination. That's the problem today. In the church, especially, I don't know why many Christians today we have such a problem. This unity in Nigeria today is about words, mouths. You see so many stories, you have about 2,500 men in Israel. You want to come to Christianity? Second World War, Italy are caused by words. I will squeeze easily Jews and split your blood. War, second starts. Nigeria Second War was caused. I remember when we had graduated, I didn't even know it. In the point of graduating, like somebody came or one of the lecturers was caused by only an English. I wonder what they don't understand English. You just throw one English. I wonder what they don't even know what to say. He ran by in the blood and come back to the airport. He said, you said at the beginning, Biafra state, Nigeria state, he used one grammar, sign it. I wonder what they sign it. I wonder what they sign in the airport. He's got a state, I wonder, you know what you sign? You sign that we know Nigeria, yeah, you do know only Biafra and Nigeria. What's that? Go on. That one was civil war. Where language? When that come from the man just said, I want it. He signed, that is a problem. People do not know what was on. Problems in the family today is the way that come from our mouths. If you can be able to control it, the way you address people, the way you talk to people, sometimes people feel you are being neglected, people feel that you don't value them. It will cause bigger so many things. I didn't even know. I thought that it
Praise the Lord.
So I was very, very careful what we say, okay. You see, if you know, he above is a thermometer. Hello? I said, he above is what?
Thermometer
to measure the level of your spirituality. He reads the way you speak. So families are in disunity today because of the war. I will kill you. You didn't even mean what you're saying, but you already tossed on. That was killed. You must be very, very careful of what you say, because that's what, see, a little baby that is less than 2 years understand the word that comes from your mouth to Jesus. Look like him, like your mama. He will not hear you, I already know this thing. One day, the devil will open the mouth when you've grown up. I don't know when this can be the my head is like my head. You'll be shocked. That's why I see children, they look at you, the way you action, the word you say. Sometimes even to the cry, what you are saying? I think they're going to resemble Ross. You don't have to be spiritual, you know what you're saying. When you are talking to the baby, carry on, I got to be there in 2006 or something. Carry my little daughter, $2. God's gift and God's promise. I think my wife is going out for a night. If we call ourselves more than 7th class, God forgive me. When we landed in Europe, we went to that place to see the woman in Africa. God didn't know them. God didn't know ourselves. The relationship is going to be just fly. If you see the girl fly, don't let go. You know where it's going to go. One leg go. Wow! I said, God, why don't you be here? No, what you do? You don't shake your head, no. Because me, nobody as a person will not let her. As a small kid, I love to do it. Don't shake his mama. When she was going to scream with the back, they know you understand. Where is that very powerful? God, if you want to say anything, wait it before you speak. And God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
He said, we want to sanctify. He said, God, if God is not sanctified, you are not a person sanctified. A sanctified God is an inness of the heart. A sanctified God is from inness of the personal inner holiness. That means, before I will speak anything that is right, it will come from the inside and inside me. I was talking to my sister. He said his brother to come and ask me if she wanted to marry another person. The lady, the guy around me coming to church here, he walked in that day. The lady told me that I have a woman that the only one that can talk to me, and anything he tells me to stop now, stop. The guy walked in, wanted to see me, I want to marry another one. He said, wow. What did that one do? I said, that one is a thief. He said, wow. He said, well, I'm wrong that they had a stroke. You know the problem. Had a stroke. Sometimes you give the girl a car. The girl will go out. His wife will go out and now, after that, he bring the money. Sometimes he said, I'm going to market. Let me turn your phone. In the other side. Well, that man is living the other side of his house where you have. The woman will keep the phone, charging it, go out. When you will go with his ATM, he will come back and delete it from his phone. Because if the man is before, he will get direct alert. So she will delete it before giving it for us. Sometimes when they go like, she takes it to their market place. So I see, we charge it to a white way. But the reason why charging is to delete the information that I come. They let them find out. I told the young man, I didn't know you two were saying, but you are at fault. And now your uncle, your elder brother is at fault. I said, you have come with another girl to marry again. He said, yes. There's one fight you must fight. He said, you must fight the fight of honor of one life. Your father married 5 wives. The father, the girl, made 2 people. And the only person that will be at the cost of that one is the most elder brother, because he wants to say, he married, he gave only girls, he didn't have one. You, this lady now, the girl I'm talking about put to bed for him the fourth issue. I said, you refuse to go and work on your wife. He said, hey, you are just giving her all she needs. It is when I was told that sister that she opened up that when they brought that girl to their house, she told them this one is not your wife, say get out. He said, that girl have had 2 kids. They say it's a lie. And the point was delivering the first issue and said, no, you should be hoping that she had delivered one boy in the house with the father called the father's and before mine. He said it's a lie, it's a two. Later now she has said that it is two. I said, I can see why I told your brother, you are the cause of your problem. wish you die, then you want to marry another one. You are just complying to the pattern of the line of your father. And you will not know at the point of this one, you are going to marry the third one. And you mean the one that will go to is a good. What your father did, what other people. He said, all my brother that are married, I have no problem in marriage, but they refuse to marry a second one. You are the one that stepped inside. He said, you are not understand. See, sometimes study your family. He said, Dad, he said, my mother's family, they are suffering diabetes. He said, I put my sisters earlier, let us fast and fight against this particular problem. But I said, they get away. He said, I told them that my blood is bitter, that diabetes cannot enter. He said, my elder sister and I, for 3-6 years, is at the core of that diabetes. You go to study your family. Ask about it. I don't know what even makes say something like that. They suffer something like that. He grew up and went to find him. In the end of 55 years, everybody in the place, their father died. Grandfather died. He reached his school. He said, Lila, you don't go to church. Go to camp. Go to conference. Go to everywhere. He said, I don't want to die at the age of what? 55. Problem that some of us are comfortable. There are things you discover that is a problem to your life. Don't fight it. Rise up and fight. Bible says, fight the good fight of faith. There's something that I want to talk about here, not today. But it will help us. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God is going to remind us that it's very, very important. Matthew chapter 5, verse 20. Remember, holiness is not of age, though. Someone is saying, when I'm 50 years, I will be holy. Holiness will start from the day you are born. Matthew 5, 20. Verse 20. Alright, verse 20. He said, for I say unto you that the same righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the scribe and Pharisee. You shall no case enter into the kingdom. Faith chapter 3. I will read verse 10. Verse 10. For he that will love life and see good days, let him refrain his tongue from evil and his lips that they speak no death. You want to get married? You're marrying a man. With this one, give birth. Who told you? Are you God? I told people, do you know the problem of having marriages today? Problem of marrying a man comes when you come where you want to come in. It's a very big problem. I was a man of somebody, do you know what that man marriage? A young girl was married by her son. And why she was married to your son? To be her helpmate. Which you, mama, cannot be. You are helpmate, but someone sent somebody that can be the boy's helpmate. Hey! Instead of understanding your position as the mother of the house, you want to fuse yourself to the position of a helpmate to your son. I prayed my son in university. Pray him to get a master. Travel abroad. Now my son is making money. Instead of taking care of me, now you remember he's going to marry and take care of me. Lie, yo. You don't go have to. Instead of this marriage, you scatter. Scatter, who are you dealing with? Dealing with your son and your son. Because when your son not have peace, you don't have peace. You won't
we start to hear. People come to me and say, this one is a lie. I said, it's a lie. But I said, please stop talking. Talking wrong and well from your mouth. It defines the power of God in you. People are saying anything they like. They call them of anything they don't care. They say, who cares? Somebody cares though, because it's someone that lives the life that you are living. And that little life you have is gone. Every life we are living here is a goal. My brother, I know for you when I'm growing to grow clothes, but I know some of my friends, if you borrow clothes, some of them will come by, they borrow shirts, borrow dresses. But the boy, if they are not careful, they are very, very careful. If they are hiring, if you are very careful, then they hire you to do what? If for the mentor, you are wearing the things here, now I have everyone in the city will let you borrow your clothes. And if you meet, if they don't know where you are, you maintain. Because if you do too much, you are not the best for us. No, sir, if you do like this, you are the best for us. I do know why I'm telling you. When your mind is filled with happiness, so you are because you are making it not close as a cross. Take it easy now. Don't say, but this is the other. I need to move to our maintain the rich. I don't forget to this room. I will carry out. If you hear something, you don't die that day. You go as well. You don't go to Jesus' name.
Amen.
Give you support and support in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Imagine on the daily ceremony. Brother Zacharias, the man is not lying down. The child will be back up and then move before you enter the water with the chair, with the bed. And the bed shows that you are, if you move like the dog, say it's time, right? If you move to the group, then you say, you better make money. So the man is still alive. But after a while, the man is too skilled. They brought the chair, they brought somebody standing, not falling down. And they brought the man to walk out. You know, when they greet the priest, right, they went to the body of him to bow down. And the moment he said, they said, Charles, how far? Can it happen? He said, Ram, how far? Ah, this one is a little. Some of the church, they watch him first, they say, one month, 2 months, 3 months, 5 months, 6 months, 9 months. And the 9 months, they said, they don't know what will happen. He said, give me paper. He wrote the name of God in the right book of pronouncing his name. A prophet cannot be able to pronounce the name of his son. Bible said that as he was writing J, O, N, J, or H, before he can put N, he said, John. Because when he said John, his father was saying, he said, there are no anyone in Allah that are answered John. Because they know what the answer in Allah is. How many do we answer John? Only those said that his name shall be called John. But because of doubt, of the war, come to Allah. Isaiah chapter 6, never to understand in the days of Isaiah. Isaiah still used unclean lips, man that is unclean to speak. And God said, look at you because you will barely say to him. Say, wow, I have been speaking nonsense. I have been praying your name, saying so many things. Say, Lord, forgive me. Bible said that the seven women and then the living come, touches his tongue. And his son was made clean. And now it is not that God said, who shall I send? Who will go? Isaiah said, I am here, send me Lord. It's not Jesus Christ who is Isaiah. Because of what Isaiah has been saying with his mouth. A prophet, what he said with his mouth. So that happened to us. What we say with our mouth. When we mix up with the sheep, with people around us, and we go to doubt on what they are saying. Living the life, you go to the level where you're not supposed to be. You go to talk like them. And when you talk like them, you will not go down. It is when you realize that what you are saying is not what you're supposed to say. There's a time when they say something, you just run. People say, you are not calling, you are just minding yourself. There's a time, as I think you say, what you say? This morning, I said, me, I don't believe you. You need that. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So it is very, very important. That's why the Lord sent the baptism of Holy Spirit. And he has given you and me an opportunity to be changed in our thoughts. Matthew chapter 12. And then to chapter 5. Holy Ghost have come to change your thought. Matthew chapter 12. And then to chapter 5. How long is it?
I'm a witness.
I don't make you feel good. Okay. Or is food good? Or else make the tree corrupt or is too corrupt? For the tree is known by its food. All generation of vipers. Yeah. How can you be evil? Speak good things. For out of the abundance of the heart, the man who was.
Speak it.
A good man out of the good treasure of his heart, bringing forth good things. An evil man out of the evil treasure of bringing forth evil things. Now Jesus Christ is relating our world here as a tree. Jesus Christ is related to our world here as a tree. He said, it is very, very important to understand that the heart is a tree. And the fruit of the word that comes from our heart, from our mouth, is the fruit. What you say from your mouth is the fruit of what is in your heart. Come on. Can anybody hear what I'm saying now? The heart is the tree. You have grown. Maybe you have something that like you're going on, you're packing it. If then you force it out, it is the fruit that comes from your mouth. There is no way the heart and the mouth. Heart cannot do anything or mouth do anything without the heart. Because everything mouth will say will come from the heart. That's why I said, Mark chapter 7:22, I said, what defines a man is not what he eats from the mouth, but what comes from inside man. So heart and mouth work together. No one confession says, a confession says, out of the heart, man believe it, but the man do what? Speaking of salvation. So if you don't believe, say, what? Say, I don't want to give my life to Jesus Christ. The man prayed, because of his confusion, he didn't persuade him. No way, that day is the last day of the care. You refuse Jesus Christ because of your boyfriend. After that service, he didn't go in and come up and down, and that's the end. When they told him, the man of God to God, he said, if I am wrong, I will persuade you. What should you persuade her? He said, give your life to Jesus Christ. He said, no, if I give my life to Jesus Christ, my boyfriend will disappear from me. That means you so much apart from my boyfriend. You don't know what God has done for you for giving your life to God. And you don't know what you have done good you have done for yourself. The greatest gift that can happen to someone is life in Christ. And the blessings in Christ. When you are dying, you are laughing and smiling back to your creator. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So you must understand your heart must be connected rightly, so that your mouth will speak rightly. Because you know that the gossip will destroy. Peter denied Jesus Christ three times. Even Paul, he said, if I know this man, let him have a cross. If I know this man, let me go cycle from the wrong side. He vowed and vowed, he didn't know Christ. But remember, Jesus Christ said, he's the one that got him to come to himself. Christ said, this man is going to be crucified. He said, you, no, go die. He said, oh, Peter, I will kill him for the Christ. Oh, Peter, oh. Peter, I was telling you, before you come, cross you die. You don't swear to God when he dies. Peter said, you know, they cannot be crucified. Yeah, yeah.
And thou hast strengthened the feeble knees.
Thou wilt have upholden him. he was born because. See, that matter to my father. To tell my father that the man died before, may he and that day because. He was also in there. Read it from that chapter 4 or chapter 5. The mother went and sent me saying to my father that the man died and was born. May he because. May the day he said was born because. Imagine the kind of anger because of present situation. He was so angry to cross him the day he was born. Sometimes God is a merciful God. I will have asked the man question if the man is alive. I said, what you are then you are born and now you are ending. Which one is better? But we don't understand that the end of Job was far, far, far better than the day he was born. May our death be better in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So you must be very careful what you say to your mouth. He said, it is the word of God that will uphold you when you are falling and strengthen your knees when you pray. Make sure you make a positive confession. And I know that God will strengthen us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Shall we pray?
Amen.